the dy and then the delta y, they're just off by a little bit. Okay, in this video, I'm going to discuss the difference between delta y and dy. And to do this, I will just begin by drawing a picture for you guys. And let me also pick a specific function to work with for demonstration purpose. Let me just use square root of x, because this is not too easy, nor not too difficult. And then from here, I will pick a point, but I'm not going to use 0, 0, nor 1, 1, because they're too boring. Let me pick 4, 2, because when x is equal to 4, the y value is nicely equal to 2. So, you know, it's a nice point to work with. Now, I will pick another point. And for this right here, I will pick an easy point. I'm going to choose 9 for the x. When x is 9, you see that the y value is going to be square root of 9, and that's precisely equal to 3. So that's nice, right? And from this picture, you see we have two points. This was our original point. We went from this point to here, and then we went up to get to the new point. This right here is precisely the change in the x values. And we can put down the delta right here to stand for change. This triangle, that's the delta, stands for change. And similarly, we went up from 2 to 3, and this right here will be the delta y. And based on this picture, I can do some computation for you guys. Delta, let's do delta y first. Delta y, we went from 2 to 3, so you can just do 3 minus 2. The change is 1. But let me actually write down square root of 9 minus square root of 4. Right, because I plug in the x values into the function to get the y values, and then this gives me a nice number 3, and this is 2. So in this case, delta y is 1, and that's nice. And the delta x, as we can see, we went from 4 to 9, so that's just 9 minus 4, and that's equal to 5. And we're done. This right here was so easy because I chose 9 on purpose to just make everything easy, and that's it. What if I didn't pick 9, but instead maybe I pick 5, maybe I pick 7? This is harder, And I will just draw the picture right here again. I will still have the same square root picture, of course. And I still have the 4, 2. And let me just say, I am going to pick the x value being 4.5. Let's pick 5, yeah? Just 5, no 4.5, just 5. So I have this new x value. Yes, you can plug in 5 into square root, and you can get the y value. And this y value right here now is going to be square root of 5. Well, we went up from 2 to square root of 5. In this case, you see, this is the delta x. We can compute that easily, but how about the delta y? Well, I'll write this down. Delta y is square root of 5 minus square root of 4, but seems like I'm stuck because I don't have a calculator with me. Okay, but that's, you know, let's put down something so we can feel like we are making progress. Delta x, this is just 5 minus 4, so this is easy. And you see, remember, x is the independent variable. You get to choose whatever x you want. And please don't comment something like, what if I choose x to be pi or square root of 57 or something? Please just pick some x values right here, because our focus is on getting the change in the y values, okay? All right. Ideally speaking, you want to have the delta x and also the delta y because they are the exact change. And let me just put this down for you guys. I mentioned the deltas stands for change, right? Delta y, this right here, is the exact. And the keyword right here is the exact. Change in the y values. And of course, we want to figure out, what if we move around along the x-axis, what happens to the y values? And yeah, ideally, if I can find the exact change, that would be perfect. But right here, I have some trouble. As I said, we are going to be using calculus. Dy and also the dx, which stands for the first derivative. And one of the interpretations for that is the slope of the tangent line. Therefore, why don't we draw the tangent line? Keep in mind, this was our given point, 4,2. Let's go ahead and draw the tangent line right here. And of course, the slope of the tangent line right here is the derivative. I will just put down dy dx. Okay, this is the slope. And now you will see, okay, if I pick x is equal to 4, plug it into the tangent line equation, I will still have 2 because they touch each other at 4,2. And if I plug in 5 into the tangent line equation, I will have this point right here. And notice though, this point in black versus this point in red is just slightly off, right? It's just off by a little bit. This point in black, this point in red, it seems like this point in red is slightly higher than the point in black. But the good thing about this is that, well, for this part right here, I can still draw the similar picture, like a little triangle. And this part is the dx part. And this part right here is the dy part. So, you see that originally we're trying to get delta y, which is this distance, it was in black right here, okay? But we cannot do that. It's okay, because I will show you how we can actually compute dy. And now you may be wondering, what exactly is dy? First, it has a special name. This is called the differential. But more importantly, you have to remember the following. Dy, it's also a change. But this right here is just approximated change in the y values. And the key right here is by using derivative. Of course, because we are talking about the slope of the tangent line. So this is the main difference. Delta y is the exact change. And dy is just the approximated change for the actual change. And to do dy, you have to use derivative. That's the main key. Okay, so right here, of course, we have to talk about derivative now, right? So here we have the equation. I will just put this down again. Y is equal to square root of x. Let's do the derivative on both sides. So on the left-hand side, I will put down dy dx. And the derivative of square root of x is 1 over 2 square root of x. And now on the left-hand side, if you look at this as a fraction of dy over dx, a ratio of dy and dx, let's multiply dx on both sides. You will see dy is equal to 1 over 2 square root of x dx. And this right here is the so-called differential. And we use differentials to do approximation for the actual change. And this right here is just pretty much derivative. And here is the deal. From here, I'm going to tell you the x value that we care, which was the 4 that we have. So x is equal to 4. And how about the dx though? Because remember, I'm doing this times that. X is 4 because that was the original. We drew the tangent line at x is equal to 4. So that will be the slope of the tangent line. The dx is this change from 4 to 5. And we are just taking the dx to be the same as the delta x. So we take dx to be delta x, in our case, it is the same as 1. And then from here, of course, we can plus 6 in. Dy is equal to 1 over 2 times square root of 4 times the dx, which is 1, like this. And we can just work this out real quick. This is 1 times 1, which is 1, over 2 times 2, which is 4. And this is 0.25. So what exactly is this then? This is telling me that, okay, originally the y value was at 2, but we went up by 0.25. So this is 2.25. And combining with everything we're saying, we're just trying to do the approximation. You see, square root of 5 is approximately the same as when you went up from 2. This is the original y value, and then we add it with the dy, namely 0.25. So I will just put this down. This was the original, and then this right here is the dy, and we are saying square root of 5 is approximately 2.25. And you see, earlier I couldn't get delta y because I cannot do square root of 5. But it's okay, because with this, I can figure out dy, and this is actually a pretty good approximation. The dx cannot be too big, meaning the distance between the original point and the new point, the difference between the x values cannot be too big. So, I will say this is a pretty good approximation. Anyway, this is it. Hopefully you guys all like this video. And if you like my video, and if you are new to my channel, please subscribe. And as always, that's it.